everybody. My name is Joey Smokey, and this is the Supplemental Instruction Series of Videos for Chemistry 121. In this episode, I'm going to be introducing the concept of nomenclature to you guys. Now, nomenclature might look like a really weird name for something, but really, all it is just naming stuff. So, as chemists, we work with a whole bunch of different chemicals and compounds and stuff like that. So it's really important for us to have a system of names for all of those different things so we know exactly what it is that we're working with and how it should be classified. As nurses, this is going to be really important for you because, you know, you're going to have to know the name of medicines and, you know, stuff you're going to be giving to your patients, so nomenclature is going to prove one of your more invaluable things that you gain from chemistry. Okay, so first thing I'm going to talk to you guys about is the two main different kinds of compounds. The first one is a covalent compound, which is always between two nonmetals. And remember, the nonmetals on the periodic table are kind of the ones up in this corner area. And ionic compounds are going to be between a metal and a nonmetal. Okay, so remember that covalent, nonmetal and nonmetal. Ionic is a metal and a nonmetal. Okay, you might be wondering, well, what about metals and metals? Do those come together? And the answer is no. Which that kind of makes sense when you think about it, because metals always have a positive charge. So you can't really force two things with the same charge to go together. That just won't happen. So you'll never see two metals bonded together. Okay, so you're going to have covalent or ionic bonds. All right. Another one you might want to be familiar with is the transitional bond, which is basically just between the transitional elements and another nonmetal. And remember, the transitional elements are basically that big block in the middle of the periodic table. Okay. So how do we name these different kinds of bonds and compounds? When you're dealing with a covalent compound, you're going to want to use prefixes to say exactly how many of each kind of nonmetal you have in that compound. Now, this is the list of prefixes that you're going to want to memorize. Maybe put them on a flashcard or something like that. Mono, di, tri, tetra, penta, hexa, hepta, octa, nona, and deca. You're going to want to know all those because these prefixes tell you exactly how many of something you have in that compound. So if you have carbon dioxide, that tells you have one carbon and two oxygens. Okay? Remember that whenever you name something, the last element part that you name, you're going to drop the last letters and replace it with an IDE ending. Okay? And we'll do another episode that kind of practices these different things to kind of show you guys how to do that. Okay? Ionic compounds. This one's a little bit tricky because you're not going to want to be using any prefixes at all. The reason for that is because you know you have a metal and a nonmetal, so you know the two charges between those things and they have to balance out. Yeah, they have to become neutral, otherwise the compound won't form. Basically, you can't have any compound that has a charge on it, okay? So with the ionic compounds, you're not going to use any prefixes when you name it, okay? You're still going to use the IDE ending. So for example, a common ionic compound might be sodium chloride, which is table salt. You have sodium, which is the metal, and chloride, which is the nonmetal. So there you go, sodium chloride, okay? With the transitional elements, since they have varying charges, the transitional metals do, you're going to want to use Roman numerals to designate what charge they have, okay? So those guys can get a little bit complicated sometimes, but basically, these are the basics for nomenclature. Go ahead and make sure you watch our practice episode. We'll have a whole bunch of different practice problems for you guys to really kind of drill it and make sure you understand nomenclature. Just remember, nomenclature is going to be very important for you guys, so you're definitely going to want to make sure you understand it. All right, we'll see y'all later.